So, in looking for the signs of God, we look for things like this. So, the earth split here for 70 miles, the ice did. And it's a chunk of ice they saying weigh, I don't know, 7 trillion pounds or something like that. I don't know who's weighing this, but for 70 miles, this, for the first time ever, this ice split. This is a major sign. And then what we doing here is we looking for these signs. You know, we're looking for the biblical signs. And basically inside of the biblical signs, we're looking for worldly signs, the signs where the Bible is pointing to you that it's going to be some kind of collapse, it's going to be some type of war, it's going to be some kind of government breakdown. And we're looking for that, you know. We're looking for the signs in the presidents, which are the beast inside of the Bible. And what's going to happen when these signs are show up, so it could be an economic collapse at first. And so when the economic collapse happen, then it's going to be like a chain of events like dominoes. Everything just start falling down from there. So God is going to end this in a perfect order. That's how he's going to end it. So up until he arrive here, smiting the shit out of everybody, you know. And again, you know, we got to be on our guard. We got to be careful. And also just take the moment to say thanks to the people who support the channel and things like that. And like I said, I'm just a watchman and I'm just doing my best, you know. And that's all I can do. I'm just doing my best to bring you information as I see it, you know, as it is revealed to me. So it get revealed to me, I reveal it to you. You know, it gets shown to me, I'll show it to you. And that's what I'm doing. And basically, a lot of things that I'm showing you is some pretty damning evidence that we are in these end times and this, you know, it's popping off, it's going down. We gotta not get sidetracked by the haters and the people that cause disputes. And what they trying to do is make you numb. What they trying to do is make you think of this place as a bad place. So when you go to Raptor News, all the haters and stuff, they're gonna keep hating so they can put an impression on your mind to say, every time I go there, it's just arguments and fighting, and because the devil is right there on your straight path. That's where he lies. He lying in wait for you, you know. And so we don't wander away from the flock, and we stay on our guard. We use the whole armor of God on this devil, you know, because he playing for keeps. He wants your asses in hell, and he does. He wants every last one of us in hellfire, and he's relentless with it. And he's an ancient ass devil. We've been along here since the beginning of you know, our time. Before our creation, he was already here before the creation of man. So basically, he had a long time to learn humans, and he gonna get you in some type of way. He gonna get you, and you ain't gonna outsmart him, you ain't gonna outthink him. Some type of way he gonna get you, you know, because he had a long time practicing that. It's like a third grader or a second grader trying to outthink you as an adult. You'll get that third grader, you know, in all different types of ways, because you've been here a long time. And that's one of the ways to look at it. So we looking for these signs, people. And these signs is telling us, like this iceberg or ice glacier melt right here, which it looks like an earthquake went through there and basically wrecked and wreaked havoc on this. So it's supposed to be 70 miles long. You know, it's down there 100 miles long. And basically, you know, seven trillion tons of ice, you know, that probably have never been broken before. It lets you know that now that it's being broken, you that much closer to the end. Raptor News.
Trying to cover here. And this article is how Jupiter split the asteroid belt in two shows its great age. Guys, this is Nibiru. Now, I know I caught a million arrows when I came out with this a few months ago after doing a lot of studying. I've done other videos since then. But most of the arrows came from YouTube people that do videos about cell phone lens flares of Nibiru in the sky. Now, guys, think about this. Just common sense. If a planet big enough to see on a cell phone that's really a lens flare came around the sun, or in millions of people would see it. And so the attacks came from there. And a lot of them, the same thing happened when you start talking about how stupid flat Earth is. I mean, it's so stupid that people have asked me, BP, please do a video debunking this. And it's like, it's so hard to dumb down to that level, guys, to even recognize it. You understand what I'm saying? I have to mention it here because I get attacked when I mention it. But let me say this. I've been a sailor for 45 years, all over the Gulf of Mexico. There's islands all over the inner Gulf, from Chandelier in Louisiana. You come east, you get Cat Island, Ship Island, Petty Boy, Horn, Deer, Dolphin. Think about it. I've been there, I've seen them all, but as you approach these islands on your boat at sea level, at first you start seeing just the top of the trees. The actual curvature of the Earth is 9.9 miles. I've also flown at 33,000 feet. Many of you have also across this nation. But at 9.9 miles, the curvature starts. So as you get 5 miles from the island, you start seeing more of the tree. You get a mile from it, you can see the tree and the sandbars and things like that. And of course, as you get closer, that's the curvature of the Earth. So just to kind of throw that on the side, it's kind of like listening to Hillary in a way. But anyway, I've said for at least maybe a year now, Jupiter is Nibiru. The ancient Sumerians call Jupiter Nibiru, guys. One of the most technologically advanced civilizations we've ever known. We are nowhere near the level that the Sumerians were. Now, I agree they had outside influence. But again, in the models that have been used in the supercomputers show Jupiter and Saturn pulling in, destroying the fifth planet, knocking big hunks off of Jupiter, creating total chaos in our inner solar system, including the Earth and the Moon, and creating the asteroid belt. So now Jupiter is the remains of Nibiru, we call Jupiter, is the fifth planet, but the actual fifth planet is the asteroid belt. Many models have shown through the rotation cycles, we have solar system, our 3D solar system on our site. There's many, many other models. But again, they have supercomputers that we don't have access to. So this approach is completely different. But they call it one hell of a bowling ball. A comparison of meteorites have revealed that in its youth, Jupiter carved a path through the solar system that separated space rocks into two separate families. And it did it within a million years of the dawn of the solar system, so Jupiter was already huge at least 4 billion years ago. Meteorites found on Earth have different proportions of isotopes of the elements in them, depending on whether they are from a rock that originated inside or outside Jupiter's orbit. That means on the inside is your asteroid belt, on the backside is millions of miles to Saturn. Now these rocks, they are seen even in those chipped off of the planets that were formed within a million years of our solar system's formation, so they must have separated before that. To have been big enough to carve such a gap in the protoplanetary disk, a cloud of dense gas and dust orbiting the newly formed sun, Jupiter's core would have had been about 20 times the mass of Earth. This new meteorite analysis by Thomas Kruger of the University of Munster in Germany and his colleagues indicate that Jupiter must have reached that size within the solar system's first million years. Now think about that, the binary twin and a failed gas giant of our sun. Many solar systems, way more solar systems have binary twins than those that don't. In other words, twin stars. But Jupiter was so massive that we're dealing with two stars, and instead of God letting this solar system collapse into a black hole, this happened. If Jupiter had completely pulled in, as these as dual gas giants do, and create a black hole, we would have, nothing would have been here. But this is in God's hands. And don't forget it. Since Jupiter is thought to have formed like other gas giants, its rocky core came first, then it gradually accreted more material from the dust and gas around the sun, and later acquired its gassy envelope. That's what's left. Kruger's team analyzed 19 iron meteorites found on Earth that originated from small bodies that formed alongside Jupiter. Now, they again observed 19 iron meteorites that were found, and they had originated from small bodies that formed alongside Jupiter. Now, let me slow this down so we don't get lost here. The isotopes of elements in the rocks that formed inside Jupiter's orbit, where we are, had more elements of the type that are slowly built up in the stars, whereas the ones from further out of the solar system were enriched in the heavy elements that form faster in high energy situations. And that is gamma ray bursts, things like that. But what that means is that once this event happened, and Jupiter collided in with what I call the, at that time would have been the fifth planet we call now the asteroid belt, that became that barrier that was even talked about in the Sumerian text. And a lot of people try to downplay some of the interpretations of the Sumerian text when very few people actually know how to read it all. And some people are much more gifted than the average Common Core graduate these days as far as archaeology and language interpretation. So some of the information out there that is proving now to be true has been blasted by mainstream science. It says the work supports one of the leading theories of the early solar system, the Grand Tack Hypothesis. This supposes that Jupiter was born a few million years before Saturn, and its enormous mass was tugged toward the sun. I've said it from day one. Once Saturn formed, however, its gravity pulled Jupiter back from the brink of stellar destruction and towards the outer solar system. So just imagine Jupiter being pulled in during solar minimum, because Jupiter has its own magnetic field. Earth's magnetic field and all the other planets are generated by the energy of the sun. But this gas giant that has failed, the binary twin, has its own magnetic system. So it's pulling in, and there's been an effect called the Jupiter wind when our magnetopause has reversed in the past, where the solar wind was actually coming from behind us. But you got to imagine this. Okay, we've got two gas giants, the Earth and Jupiter. Jupiter's being pulled in closer. It's colliding in with, at that time, the fifth planet, creating the asteroid belt. It comes in closer. Saturn finally is catching up with it as it's formed and pulled in behind it. And that gravity force pulls Jupiter back. But what happens if Jupiter's pulled back? There's a second collision within the asteroid belt, right? Of course it is. Now, again, this is called the Grand Tack. What's unique about it is this Grand Tack was proposed way before they had this isotopic labeling of these meteorites. Think about that. And it makes perfect sense. And I've said this before. So many people are looking for something coming in from way outside of our solar system. It can never sneak in. You would see it way before time, but you never see that punch, that uppercut that's coming from really close to you. You never see it. Like the old saying is, you can't see the forest for the trees, guys. And to think about it, it's close, very dangerous. It's proven that now through two different, totally different views, through the isotopes and through the modeling, that this is the destroyer. And again, in the oldest writings of this planet, the Sumerian text, Jupiter is called Nibiru. It's a heads up. Be safe.
Saudi Arabian snowfalls making the headlines over the last few days. Some of it's hail, but some of it is definitely snow. What's not talked about are the massive floods that followed that, or the hail in the multi-feet range in Mexico, the severe hail storms in Australia, the minus 40 degree Fahrenheit temperatures across Alaska, and that tongue of cold air that's going to push temperatures 30 degrees Fahrenheit below normal temperatures.
Não sei quem é esse amarelo que a gente vê aqui, não sei quem é. E como se não bastassem dois, tem esse terceiro aqui, ó, dois. Quarta situação onde tem dois sóis aqui. Se alguém puder explicar, eu agradeço.
Sorry, it's a little blurry. I can't get my phone out the window in a second. Thank you.